for this.
What in God's name is going on in here? What was that ruckus?
What ruckus?
I was just in my office and I heard a ruckus.
Could you describe the ruckus, sir?
Turn the fucking beat up!
What is that? What is that? What is that noise?
What noise?
Really, sir, there wasn't any noise.
Let's create.
Nah, not yet.
I'm ready to create now.
Nah, not yet. Hold on.
No, let's create now.
Alright, y'all, we up in this thing. It's another episode of the Skeeters. Are these even mini episodes now?
Yeah, they're still mini episodes.
It's I, Big Papa Skeeter, and
Mama Neezy.
Yeah, y'all, get used to that, okay?
London's mom.
We're parents. Damn
parents,
it.
Yay!
And pretty, like, when she get old enough to talk, we just gonna be like, hey, and we just incorporate her. It's gonna be a family podcast, you feel me?
Exactly.
Alright, updates. Struggles, challenges, successes. What do we want to share?
So she's growing each and every day. She's amazing. You know, she cries, of course, babies cry.
Mm-hmm.
But for me, it doesn't wear me out. You know what I mean? It's something I was expecting and looking forward to.
Yeah.
So I can't say I'm 100% prepared, but I prepared myself for that. You know what I mean?
The crying is not what bothers me. It's the lack of sleep. That's
but see,
like,
I've prepared for that.
You have.
I prepared for it, so I've mastered now sleeping when she sleeps. So
what about
during
me?
Our day we sleep, and then in the middle of the night I have be like, London, be quiet, daddy has to sleep.
Y'all don't care about me, man.
I be trying to keep, you know, the time, but she only wakes up twice in the middle of the night to fuss.
Yeah, but no, we had her down to one time and then she just said, you know what, I like to. And I only say that because, man, like, and you know, y'all know us, we transparent as hell. These pictures and stuff that we taking is cute, man. Okay, but it ain't nothing cute about 3:30 a.m.
when she's up and wants to play.
Yeah.
Like, but we learned that when she's up and wants to play at 3:30, that's
you gotta
when
get up and play with her.
But also, that's when she slept until 8:39. We've let, you know, we kind of let that nap run long.
Yeah.
And
I'm not having it. She's gonna have to wake up and play.
Like, those have been times where it's like we've had company and kind of just let her sleep a little bit longer. But now, when mm-hmm. our company is left, Mama did not play that. We like are back on our up. Time schedule. We up at 7 for our morning feeding. Then we back for our little nap between 9 and 10.
Yeah.
We up again, you know, around 11, 12. Then kind of back down like that. And then around 8:09 is when I start to wind her back down,
mm-hmm.
start to wash her up and put her to sleep, and then give her milk, because you know that liquid gold puts her to sleep.
She love the booby milk.
Yeah,
baby love the booby milk.
But and you know, people always be, oh, you're gonna spoil the baby if you hold him too much. It's my baby, I'm gonna spoil her no matter what.
Yeah,
because she is spoiled. Yes, she has to sleep with her hand on my face.
I can still feel the love. No, she do that. That's weird. I woke up in the morning and it's like the third night in a row where that's happened.
She has to feel me. She makes sure that I'm still there.
She reach over and she got your face like holding it, like, don't you move now, mommy, you be still so I can sleep here.
That's why I like her in the co-sleeper. But I mean, that's because she's smaller right now. But
that
as
also
she gets
takes
bigger
up space in the bed.
When she gets bigger, she's gonna move to the bassinet that's next to me on the other side.
We got,
and
like,
then,
if you're listening right now, and shout out to everybody who bought off the registry, we got like the baby got like 30 places to sleep, right? So she got a crib in her room, which we ain't put her in there yet, because you know what I'm saying,
she's still too small.
Yeah, we'll put her in the crib, like if we sitting in here in the room and stuff, but we don't put her in the crib and leave her in there. She got a bassinet that we keep by the bed that she slept in a little bit, but mostly not. Okay, she sleeps in the co-sleeper, so go look that up if y'all like, what's a co-sleeper? It's 2021, so you know what I'm saying, technology has evolved, you can have a co-sleeper. And then she had what we thought was supposed to be like a playpen, which
it is a playpen.
Which, guess what, guys? It's just another bassinet.
And it's a playpen. It's
so,
both.
So we could have just had one.
No.
We had the two in one. But guess what? No.
You need it for the living room. That goes in the living room.
Okay. Our new place is big. It ain't that big. Okay? It ain't that big. Like, half the time we pulled just a bassinet out.
Look here. She goes from room to room, and in every room she has a place to sleep.
And guess who has, like, one room and still can't get no sleep? It's okay. I signed up for this. I didn't say space. I'm okay with the space. I'm talking about, like, no sleep.
Just put you some earphones on.
And then when y'all, babe, because don't act like
you still
don't
be. I'll just throw something at you.
Don't act like you still don't. You know I got to go to work. You like, babe, can you get up and do such and such? Nigga, I got to go to work in the morning.
Sometimes I need you to get up because I'm still healing too.
You're fine. No, I've been watching you. You're okay.
No, my hips be hurting a little bit.
Okay, Shakira. Your hips are lying. You lie.
No, my hips
be niggas
hurting.
Lie. You worship him.
I just don't move as fast.
You're okay. I've been watching you. You're fine. I think you hamming it up a little bit.
If you say so. I go to the doctor on Monday.
Yeah, we're gonna get to the bottom of your bullshit.
But then, you know, London will be 4 weeks this Friday, guys.
Yeah.
4 weeks.
One. Are we gonna do that? Oh, she's 82 weeks.
No, nah, I'm not doing that.
She's 52 weeks.
Just now.
She's 1 month. She will be
here,
1 month.
We are back on our Skeeters episode. So we're 4 weeks. Our anniversary is coming up. Mommy is healing.
She's trying to run it back. So she's trying to make another. She's like, all right, that'll be 6 weeks right there. If you go ahead and just pop another one in there. I'm like, bro, can we enjoy what we have?
No, not at 6 weeks. We have to wait till she's 18 months before we have
Wait till she's
one.
A year old?
18 months.
I just asked if you was going to beat them people, and you was like, we not going to beat them people, and now you are 18 months. Nigga, that's a year. She's a year, a one-year-old.
It's a little over a year.
It's a year.
So, and then we will have baby number two.
Who trying to have more babies? You or Nick Cannon?
No, Nick Cannon got me beat, bro.
Yeah, so he just had, I think they say he got seven altogether, seven or nine. He up
because he has one on the way now.
Yeah, well, and so at first, and you know, Mama Lo talked about it. She just couldn't stand it. And then I think we talked about it last week. Again, I don't remember what we talked about in previous weeks. Freestyle. But Nick Cannon, like, at first it was like, oh, he's trying to preserve his legacy and you know, because he could die at any day because of his lupus. But then now it's like, nah, he's trying to see about getting a bone marrow transplant. So, like, really what he doing is, like, you know, to get a bone marrow, like, you got to be on the list and do all
yeah,
that.
Yeah, you do.
So now it's like, not if I create my own, which you can't be mad at that. I'm not even.
But I mean, what I'm thinking is, wouldn't these kids be a little too young for the bone marrow?
In 5 years. I think it's like the minimum age is like 5 years. So assuming he'll be around that long, you know what I'm saying? God willing, you know what I'm saying?
Well, he has other kids that are a little bigger, right?
I think so. Mariah's twins, but Mariah ain't going for that. Let him die.
But then I think it's like another one aside from the twins.
I didn't even realize that he was having, I stopped keeping track.
The only reason I know is from Wildin' Out, because they be cracking all them jokes like, man, you got so many kids.
That's the only thing I know about Nick Cannon's love life. It wasn't until Mama Lo brought it to our attention.
Exactly.
And then, so not to blame her, but then, like, that's all I've been hearing about afterwards now. Like, and I refuse to, you know, I'm a journalist, right? So I do my journalistic deep dive. I refuse to go look it up.
Yeah, it's not that important to me.
Because it's all about family. We tried to find Fast Five. Not Fast Five, my bad. Fast and the Furious Nine. I'm four late. That's London in the background, if you can hear. So tried to find Fast Nine. It's not on HBO Max. They lied. They just loaded all the other HBO. I told y'all I'm
sleepy. Fast and the Furious back on there.
I'm sleepy. But we found some movies. So we was chilling with London. We watched, what was the first one we watched?
The Tomorrow War.
What's our dude?
Is it Chris Pratt?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep. Who we like, dog. But this movie was ass. It was ass-tastic.
You got that? You got ass-tastic from Couples Retreat. Yep.
ASSTASTIC.
I got to meet Vince Vaughn, y'all.
We know he tried to slide on you in Vegas. You're not gonna let us live that down.
He did not try to slide.
He's like, hey, little mama.
He said, hi, beautiful.
See, that's even worse. Boom. He lucky I ain't kick him in his shin.
In the MGM Grand Hotel.
He was a tall nigga.
He is. I didn't realize he was that tall. But sorry, I got off topic.
He looked down. He was like, hey, chocolate drop. I'd like to drop that chocolate.
Yeah, right. Germaphobe.
But no, Tomorrow War was a bunch of time travel foolishness.
With monsters, and then he went into the future to kill these monsters. And
he met his daughter, which, spoiler alert, yeah, we spoiling it, because if you, I mean, whatever.
Everybody should have seen it by now. It's been out a few days.
And if you didn't, you ain't missed much, man. It was mindless action. We, and you know us, so our
thing.
We
love some action.
Our thing is, we'll watch a movie and tear that movie to pieces. Like, the realism, the logic of it all, the fact that they was just taking random people off the street and sending them over there to die, and was still expecting.
We could do movie reviews, for real.
Yeah. And they were still expecting them to, like, deliver. It's like, bro, these niggas ain't had no training or nothing. Half the people didn't even survive, like, being transferred to the future. They fell off a building and got their heads cracked.
That was the number one of the number one issues I had. Because, like, y'all going to transport me, but transport me in a secure location. Don't just drop me out the sky. Folks was falling and, like, if you've seen Titanic, mostly everybody has.
Rose,
dude was Jack. The way that they was dropping the folks in, it's like how the man fell off of the edge of the ship and hit the propellers.
Oh damn,
do you remember that part?
Yeah
he hit and kept spinning. That's how these people was dropping out the air, hitting sides of building, falling in pools, just smacking dead on the concrete.
Just keep spinning, y'all.
Exactly.
But yeah, so we watched that one. Then we ended up going to Nobody with our man's. I know Dog's name, but Better Call Saul is the best way to
yeah,
that
that's
we can
all
describe.
I don't know his name.
What was your thoughts on that?
It was like a John Wick knockoff.
Yeah.
It really was like a John Wick knockoff. You can tell that
Don Wick.
You can tell that they watched it and was like, we want to have a fighting action like this. Okay, bring it on, guys. Let's fight all these guys on the bus. But
He wasn't believable to me.
Exactly, because it's like, okay, no, we can take him as like the little nerdy lawyer dude, but as a crime fighter,
the description, action hero. Hold on. The description was like, oh, he went in to be a vigilante. No, he just was mad and started a fight.
Exactly.
As somebody who's been mad before and started fights, I can understand.
But they could have gave us a little bit more of his combat background, so then we could know why they'd be like, yeah, man, he can do it. You know, you just were staying calm in this situation.
Yeah, because so if y'all haven't seen it, he's this unassuming guy who just commits to this just mundane ass life. You know what I'm saying? And somebody breaks into his house. Some bums break into his house. And I call them bums because they ain't steal shit. They have some old dusty ass revolver or this or that. And he could have beat one over the head with a golf club, but he didn't. And then they ended up punching his son in the face and ran. So his family looking at him like, you soft, why you do that? But then everybody who know him, like, we know you a killer. So, like, we understood why you let them live. It wasn't even worth it. But then he's mad now because he felt like, damn, I should have did something. So he just goes and picks a fight and ends up killing.
No. But you got to remember, he got really mad because his daughter's bracelet was missing.
You don't do that. Who steals a kitty cat bracelet? I feel him though. So the reason why I watched this movie, and you know me as my wife, since we moved to Houston, and it's going on 8 years next month, right? We're recording this in the first week of July. Second week? No, it's first week of July. First week of July. First full week of July. People be like, oh, no, Lo, like, I don't picture you like this and that. I couldn't imagine you being this way or that way. And so, like, just being all unassuming and just living a quiet, suburban, quote-unquote, boring life. And then, but you still with the shits. Like, and when you are with the shits, like, you just take it to a whole nother level. So I can relate to that, right? But they tried his daughter, man. They punched his son in the face. They stole her little bracelet thing. What was he supposed to do, bro? What was he supposed to do?
Exactly. You can't be like, can't have your kids looking at you like a punk, so you gotta take the folks out.
See, so that brings me to another point though, right? Because everybody talk about, like, you know, when you have it's like when you have your baby, especially now that you're having a daughter, it's gonna soften you up. I felt that, and you tell me if you feel this way. I don't feel that way, like, as we've gone like a month in now and stuff. Now, soft, like, around her and to her, yes. But when I go out into the world, I don't know. I feel extra like I ain't taking no shit from nobody. Fuck, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm not tolerating nothing. And if anybody get out of line, like, all of that, oh, I'm just going to extend mercy and grace. I'm slapping the shit out of niggas, everything, bro. Exactly. Like, especially, like, when it comes to family and stuff. Like, I just feel like as a provider and a protector, I got to step it up even more now, right? So all of that softening, I don't see it.
Hey, what's up, y'all? It's Neezy here. I wanted to make sure that y'all go and get your Naturally Nate Instant Moisture Duo. That's right. You know, this Instant Moisture Duo can be used on braids, locks, twists, beards, and all of your natural hair. The moisturizer is all natural ingredients. One of our key ingredients, aloe vera. You know, aloe vera is really great for your scalp. And our oil blend is a mixture of the best oils that you can use to promote hair growth and give your hair a good shine and overall just a natural glow. So you're getting two amazing products. Make sure you go to inaudibleruckus.com/naturallynay. And also you can follow us on Instagram at naturally_nay, N-A-E-E.
I don't see it.
Y'all talk about it. A protect and serve. I'm a protect and serve, all right.
Yeah, but like, I don't know. My spirit just feel even more on fire. It's like, I got to go out here and, like, kill more shit. Like conquer more shit. Like, I got to do more. Like, and I know that's not necessarily the case, but, like, I thought, oh, it's cool. We have a baby. Now it's like, no, I got to go out here and, like, kill. No, not like that. Like that. Figuratively, not literally. Sometimes. No.
Silly.
But now, how you feel? Like, do you feel the same way? You just, like, let me just, like, do you agree or not?
I did agree. You didn't see. You was too busy on your rant. You ain't listen to me.
I had because, turned up.
You know, I was already,
in a drunken rage.
I already do not play. And so,
we know.
Now that I have my baby.
I am not for the games.
Exactly. I am not for the bullshit. Even more for my baby. Because I'm going to make sure that she's taken care of. And I'm going to make sure that when we go somewhere, she's not afraid. You know,
factuals.
So yeah, I gotta take somebody. I gotta kick them in the throat.
Your leg can't even reach that high no more. Remember, you just was in pain. Can. You just talked about how much pain you was. I bet you could rotate up and karate crane kick somebody in the neck.
I get that rush of adrenaline. And I take them out.
Yeah, sure. They gonna grab you by the leg and drag you around. Then I'm gonna have to punch them. So you said you wasn't for the games. Somebody else who's not for the games, Sh'Carri Richardson, will not be participating. That's not funny. I'm sorry for laughing, y'all. She will not be participating.
The segue was funny.
It was. I was trying to segue it up. Segue Lord. She will not be participating in the Olympics. At first, we was waiting to see. You know, she tested positive for marijuana, the THC. We was waiting to see, like, okay, if she would be able to be cleared after her 30-day suspension and then qualify in the qualifier meet or whatever. It was ruled that she will not be allowed to participate, and everybody's in an uproar. This is bullshit. Why are they doing this? Why are they doing that? Did we talk about her on the last show?
We didn't, but
what's your thoughts on this just in general?
One, she didn't just start smoking weed out of nowhere. She had to be smoking weed before. But because in the media, she probably was a nobody.
Right. We don't pay attention to track and field like that.
Exactly. Maybe she wasn't hyped up in the media. So it was like, okay, maybe she smoked, whatever. But now that she's hyped up in the media.
Hold on. No.
And she got to get her drug test for this run. It's like, oh no, y'all done hyped her up.
Is it our fault for hyping her up?
I'm not going to say it's our fault because, you know, we want to give her credit as a people. Because it's like, bruh, you fast, you good at track. We want to give you credit. It's just something that comes with the spotlight.
Right,
now
right.
That the heat is on you, you got to be like, basically, it's like how when you go to a suburb school, you got to be on your P's and Q's.
I said that, and everybody's
like,
nah.
You got to be on your P's and Q's.
But no, Neezy, it shouldn't be that way. She shouldn't have to. She's an athlete.
It's just like basketball, football, all that stuff.
No, Neezy.
You're an athlete. If you don't do, you're going to do drugs. Hey, you better pay the cost to be the boss. If you're going to do drugs, you better pay somebody off. Like, hey,
nah,
in the room, my drug tester, just pass me.
She should be able to do whatever she wants. It should be legal. Like, why are they even doing this?
Yeah, okay.
These rules are suck. Why they only make the rules for us? They didn't make the rules for Michael Phelps. Yes, they did.
That's the rules with athletic rules.
He knew
that's
how to
what
dodge
it is.
This shit. That's all I'm saying, bro.
But I'm telling you,
it's still wrong.
You can
like
dodge it. You just gotta have enough money to dodge it.
That's what I'm saying. Get your bread up. That's it. Period.
You
got to
pay off the right folks. So, and I mean, I don't think that us as a people, we're wrong for hyping her up. Keep hyping her up. Let her get the bag. But now she'll know until she has the bag.
But the thing is,
she got to be on her P's and Q's.
The thing that makes it, and I tried to explain this to, I explained this to E-Ray on the Inaudible Ruckus show, and I explained this at the barbershop. She's an Olympic athlete. Olympic athletes, one, don't get paid, two, but they only have a short window of time because, you know what I'm saying? The Olympics only come every 4 years.
And then at that, she's black. They already don't want black folks in the Olympics.
Yep.
So when you're
unless
doing
it's basketball.
That, exactly. So when you're going to the Olympics in these different kind of fields, you gotta be on your toes. Mm-hmm. You cannot slip up because they're gonna look for any, they're looking for any little thing to slip you up.
Yeah.
Like, oh shit, she said nigga on Twitter.
Yep.
And it's like, yep. So we can't be condoning that.
She should
like,
be able
they're
to
looking
say whatever
for any little thing. And I mean, that's just the way to land. It's sad to say it, but you gotta call it like it is.
This is the truth right here, right? We live in America. You can literally do whatever you want in America. Now, the caveat to that is you can do whatever you want, but you're going to have to deal with whatever consequences come from doing whatever you want. You could go out here right now and punch a police officer in the face, but if you get locked up for assaulting an officer, then you know what I'm saying? Like you got to take what comes with that. Those are the rules. Well, you should be able to punch police officers in the face because blah, 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 blah. What I'm supposed to say. You know what I'm saying? Like, come on, y'all. And I get that. Y'all in y'all feelings, and we got to make change, and we got to do this and that. Now, the fact that she can't participate in the Olympics, the basketball players should just protest. Let's see if they really going to do that shit, though. They should be like, nah, this ain't right. Because I've been saying this for the past however many years. If y'all really wanted to end social justice, I mean, not end social justice, end social injustice or whatever, like, stop sending all our star athletes over to the Olympics. Let us get washed up by, like, you know what I'm saying, the European countries. Let the Czech Republic, like, run all over us on the basketball court. Let Lithuania, like, ball out on niggas. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you go over there, you send the 4 or 5 white boys to run on the basketball court, and when they don't produce, you're going to be like, damn, maybe we should, because black people represent us on a high level.
Exactly. The moment that your athletes and everything sit down and all this stuff starts to be forfeited,
that's what, yeah.
Then I think they will take it serious.
Yeah. I don't know, though. But it is unfortunate. But, I mean, the rules is the rules. And you know what I'm saying? I what I do respect about her is she took accountability for it. And it's like, all right, bet. You know what I'm saying? I got to roll with it. But everybody else got to understand that, too, man. Accountability, bruh. Like y'all always want. And this is for everybody out there, man. Like, niggas be wanting to duck the work. And, like, duck, like, again, you want to do what you want to do, but you don't want to deal with the consequences and ramifications of, like, what you do, bro. And I know some of y'all listening out there, ramming for what? Nigga, like, if you violate, you got to pay the penalty is basically what niggas have said. Flat out. What, you know you always got some relationship advice up in here. What you got for us tonight?
Make sure that you love your partner unconditionally.
But I got conditions.
Never take them for granted.
I have conditions.
Never take them for granted. Like, I mean, you know, so much happens each and every day. But
each and every day.
And what I can even say, I mean, y'all know, Lo and I, we love each other. Definitely.
Do we?
We have our ups and downs, but we have a unbreakable bond. Like,
more ups than downs.
Nobody's
though.
Perfect, but he's perfect for me.
True that. More ups than downs, though.
Oh, yeah. We definitely have more ups than downs. And then we have this little beautiful little baby.
The munchkin.
But what I'm saying is, because you see so much that be going on in the media today and then even in the world, like real life folks, too. But it's just when you have somebody who's by your side, like the way that Lo is with me and vice versa,
mm-hmm.
you hang on to that, you know,
the world too cold of a place, bro.
It is. And it's like when you got somebody that's going to ride or die for you.
Hold on a second now.
When you got somebody that's like that, and it's like you cherish those moments, you know, and you cherish that person.
Mm-hmm.
and you just keep it. And I mean, you have to, everything you have you're to work
gonna,
towards it.
You're not going to find no peace in
and you streets. Have to continue to work on it. You know what I mean? Yeah. Nothing is easy. So
I
you got to work at it.
I will say this to you, because you mentioned like just kind of the unconditional nature of things. You know, we all as people grow and like develop, you know what I'm saying, differently. But I think that, you know, being in a committed relationship is really the key, right? And I only say this because, again, y'all, if y'all listening out there, how you date in your 30s is not the same as how you dated in your 20s, bro. And I think we got to start, like, realizing that. And I say we, like, our era of people and stuff, man. Like, you're not out here young just trying to just get it off, man. Like, at some point, you got to start thinking, like, you know what I'm saying? Am I building something? You don't want to be one of them 45, 50-year-old motherfuckers and you out here, you know what I'm saying? Like, damn, like, I got to get my shit together. Now, some people, you know what I'm saying, you built early and then now it starts to crumble or it falls apart and stuff. Okay, you can't be scared to rebuild. That just means it wasn't, you know what I'm saying? You got to build a different way. But ultimately, man, like, you got to be in it and committed to the person that you're trying to build with. A lot of times we just want to be us and that's it. And we don't want to come up with no level of compromise, no level of, you know what I'm saying, like sharing. You're sharing a life with somebody.
Exactly.
A life. Like, it's not yours anymore, right? Niggas gotta learn how to share, bro. Like, y'all are sharing like a soul, basically, like under God's
eyes. Yeah, two become one.
But the other thing is, and now I'm about to get all preachy, because y'all know we the oldest young couple, but we the youngest old couple. Okay, yeah, run that back, makes sense. The youngest old couple, but the oldest young couple. Y'all gotta put God in your relationships, bro.
And y'all gotta put God first in your relationship.
You feel me? Like, and I know it sounds all preachy stuff, but that's the difference. You know what I'm saying? We out here just doing shit, bro. And it's like, nah, that ain't the way it worked. You feel me? Like, and then this marriage shit is serious because everybody just look at it like, what the fuck we need to get married for? The government. You know what I'm saying? We inviting the government into our house. It's deeper than that. Like when you talk about like the uniting of two souls into one under God, bro.
Yeah, and like y'all have to be. And I always say this, like, yes, you have to be afraid and sad of disappointing your significant other. But also, you really got to be afraid of disappointing God. Like, when you have your marriage and, you know, folks is out here cheating and folks is out here, you know, doing whatever they're doing. It's like when you sit and you talk to God and it's like, just think of how God is like, you're cheating on this person that I put with you. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Just like think of like how disappointing you, like the disappointment that you're getting from God. The
accountability.
And it's just, that's always my thing too. And like, of course, you know, y'all know I'm a germaphobe, so I ain't even thinking about that because it's so many other nasty factors that come into being with another person. Cheating,
you know what?
That.
You know what? You a germaphobe. Give me a tongue kiss. Come tongue kiss me right now.
I'll kiss you.
Give me a tongue kiss.
Yeah, I'll tongue kiss.
Give me
you.
A tongue kiss.
I will.
You want a tongue kiss?
Mm-hmm.
You want a tongue kiss?
Yeah, I'll do
that's
that.
That's another sound. Hold on. When there's a baby in the room.
But I'm just saying, like, for the folks that do it, like they do it to their spouse, and then they be like, out here, yeah, let me just randomly kiss this girl in the mouth, and you be like, hey. You just met her at the club.
I done been in the, hey, I ain't gonna say no names, but you remember we went on that one trip with that one friend.
I know, that's and we why looked I was over, just saying it.
And we looked over, and he was just full-fledged, tonguing that girl down in the mouth next to the speaker.
But I mean, that's how you get herpes.
Trichomonosis, mono.
Exactly. Y'all get cold sores on your lips from folks.
Niggas walking around.
Which is herpes. What?
Niggas walking around here with that
bump bumps. Yeah. But I mean, that's always been my thing. Like, when you say these vows, you really have to mean it, because again, you're saying these vows in honor of God that you're going to do this. So don't play, and don't play with God. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, don't be playing with God now. Mm-mm. But nah, I feel you on that. And it's just, I don't know, part of us. So we do the Skeeters episodes, like, just one, just to show y'all that we regular, normal people. We just be kicking it. We don't be trying to be out here like, look at us, we married, ha ha, what's up? Oh, this is amazing. It is amazing, but we just trying to show, like, if you want to be married, like, nigga, like, you got to, like, love each other.
Exactly.
Like, that's it.
Maybe we should start doing some snippets too of some video snippets of the Skeeters.
Like how we used to?
Yeah, let the people see us here, like how we just be chilling and lounging, but
they don't look at these bums. They don't do nothing but sit on the couch and play with their baby.
No, we can make it lovey dovey, you know.
We can do that. You wanna start doing that? Okay, you gotta produce it though, cause you be making me do this shit and you be like, you don't be ready.
Yeah, sure.
That means it's more work for me, bro.
We got it, player.
I'm tired, man. I'm tired. Look, you making me do this now. I got to go to sleep. tell them where they can find your stuff.
Make sure y'all go to Instagram and you go follow naturally_nay with 2 E's. And again, we are the black girl with the braids, not that other person. And you can go to audibleruckus.com/naturallynay and get your instant moisture duo off the site.
And go to inaudiblerecords.com/shop, midnightclubmerch.com. Go to, you can look up Gross Power Washing and Cleaning. Also, Muse Lux Aesthetics Beauty Studios, man. It's another episode of the Skeeters, Minisodes. You know that I'm the